We are in the book of the nature. What does it mean? It means that nature, through symbol, through evidence, teach to us how to feel better. What does the nature teach at this moment? Nature teach the eternity, the space. You can feel the space in the nature. The eternity. We are made of this space, this eternity. No judgment, no concept, no blabla, no advices, no belief, nothing. We are made of this eternity. We are made of elements, made of atoms, the same atoms that you can see everywhere here. We are made of these atoms. We are made of eternity, space, the atom of freedom. We come from the eternity. And the last day of our life, we go back to the eternity. We go back to the space. But during our life, we can feel the space. We can feel the eternity. And we need this silence. We need silence. Silence is the food of our mind. The food of our soul, pure vacuity, no thought, no talk, just we are in eternity, in silence. This is one of the main chapters of the book of the nature. The nature is our mirror. We are the mirror of the nature. We can be in eternity. And now we go back home. We are not in the desert. We are in the city. But you see, nothing has changed. I know when I say that to you, it can surprise you, because you can say, "No, Michel, we were in Joshua 3, in the desert, and now we go back to the city." No, this is the same. All is in our mind. We can be stressed in Joshua 3. I saw many people, they came to drink alcohol, to talk a lot for futilities, and they were stressed. And we can be so calm in the city. We don't live in a city. We don't live in Joshua 3. We live in our mind. This is so important, what we say. I can surprise you, but this is exactly what proves science. Everything that we see, that we perceive, that we visualize, this is a mental construction. Our brain make a projection. For example, when you see me, you don't see me. When we see the desert, we don't see the desert. When we see the city, we don't see the city. When our brain has the perception of the city, the first perception of our brain, when you see me, when you see Je suis tu, when you see the city, when you see anything, the first perception is not real. The brain doesn't know what it's looking for. 2 milliseconds after, 2 milliseconds, the brain active the concept that we have created, that we were educated. We are educated that the desert is quiet, that the city is stress, but it's a mental habit, it's a concept, it's a cognitive reaction according the concept that we have created, according the concept that we were educated, according our mental habit. For example, for me, to be in a big city, to be in a company, to be in the traffic, it's a quiet place. Because my mind is quiet. We can be in Je suis tu, we can be in the city, we can have the same calming energy. All is a question of conditionment. All is a question of mental projection. And when we have a mental projection, when we create a cognitive reaction in our brain, we have a neurochemical reaction. It's hormonal. For example, when we see Je suis tu, we say this is the desert. So immediately we create a lot of serotonin that we send in every cells of our body. So just to see Je suis tu, just to see a desert, upgrade the serotonin, the hormone of the well-being. And this well-being, it's not a concept, it's a sensation. We feel a calming vibration in our body. But when we calm our mind in the city, this is what we are doing at Amity. Every session at Amity Foundation, we train our mind to calm our mind in our daily life. We can feel the same peace at Amity Foundation that we feel in Je suis tu. Of course, it's more difficult, but it is possible. How can we do that? How can we feel the same peace in the city that we feel in the nature? Of course, For example, it's important to watch again and again this video. Because in this video, at the beginning, with Je sois tu, we are connected to the Mother Nature. We are connected to the calming energy. And the difficulty that we have when we go back to the city, it's we forget. We forget. Je sois tu, we forget the desert. Immediately, we go back in our mental habit. So, when we calm our mind at Amity, when we meditate in the desert at Amity, this is what we will do in a few minutes. We change our concept of Amity. We re-educate our perception of the city. We realize that we can be calm in the city, like we can be calm in the desert. And this is the most important, to calm our mind in the big cities, to calm our mind in the chaos, in the middle of the stress, especially in our time. Our time is very stressful. So we need to go deeper and deeper to the desert. Where is the desert of Je sois tu? Here, in our mind, all is in our consciousness. Everything that we perceive, that we feel, that we see is in our mind. So when we meditate like a desert in the city, day by day, what's happening? We change our perception, our concept of the city. And the city becomes more and more quiet because our mind is quiet. There is no desert in Je sois tu. There is no city in Los Angeles. There is our projection. Life doesn't exist. What exists? Our interpretation of the life. This is the same for all. This is the same for the time. Time doesn't exist. For example, sometimes we see a film. When we watch the film Titanic, of James Cameron. This film is close 4 hours. We have the sensation at the end of the film that the time was 1 hour because the film is very intense. Sometimes we are watching a film of 1 hour and we have the sensation this film took 2 hours. All is a mental projection. All is in the consciousness. When we realize that we can be calm in the city, we are liberated from the concept, from the mental prison of our concept, our projection. We realize that we can live in the desert, in the middle of the city. And every day we meditate as we do. Every day you are watching these videos. You share with your friends these videos. You realize, we realize together that at the moment we calm our mind, we enter in the desert. The desert is a representation of our soul, of the eternity. I love in the gospel when Jesus say, I need to go to the desert. We need to go back home. We need to go back to the silence, to a life with no stress, no tension. Let's go back to the desert in the city. Let's meditate like in Joshua Tree, but in the city. I snap 3 times and just we close our eyes. We are sitting down in the middle of the city of Los Angeles. We are sitting down in the middle of the desert. And just when we recreate the sound of the wind in the desert, we really feel the desert in our consciousness, like that. Listen, the wind in the desert, all together. No talk, just we are listening to wind in the desert, in our inner desert. It's good to be sitting down in the middle of the desert. This is so beautiful to be sitting down in the middle of the desert. Let's do it again a last time. Let's recreate the sound of the wind with our breath. the desert. And we open our eyes slowly. Wow. Where do we meditate today? Are we in the desert of Joshua Tree? Or in the middle of Los Angeles, surrounded by 11 million people? You see, when we calm our mind, we can feel the same peace. The desert is here. The desert is in our mind. And when we recreate the sound of the wind with our breath, like that, we activate the mental picture, the concept that we have of the desert. In our world, especially in this time, the more our world is challenging, difficult, the more we need to calm our mind, the more we need to go to the desert, to go far in the desert, and the desert is in our consciousness. I wish you can watch again and again this video. And every video can be an unforgettable experience to calm your mind. When we calm our mind, we live in a better world. We are more grateful. We are free. We are rejuvenated. Life is beautiful. Thank you so much. All my love to each of you. I am so happy to make this video for you. God bless you. God protect you. Amen.